was fighting for his life in Shortland Street.
We have to find somewhere better to meet than the park.
I've been thinking about that, and I've got a plan.
Welcome to your new home, ma'am.
We have a place completely to ourselves for the week.
From now on, our relationship will be strictly professional. I want you to leave now.
I need someone to do something for me.
He's wearing a black suit and a white shirt with a purpley checky tie.
I tried to save him. He needs to know that I didn't mean to hurt him.
Well, no, you pushed him out of the way. It's not your fault.
Don't leave him.
I have waited and waited. Please just give me some time.
Get out. Get out!
Mention me anyway.
Hey, so what's the deal with Norman?
How would I know? He sent me some text at 4 a.m. in the morning saying something about prime numbers and Stockhausen. Huh? He's drunk, obviously.
Oh, come on. But that's so bad. I mean, the brother's just trying to live his life, have fun. On the other hand...
Fun! He's not supposed to be drinking at all, and there he is again, out all night. Is he trying to kill himself? Is he punishing me? What?
Do you want me to have a word to him? You know, straighten him out.
Yeah. It'd be really neat. Hey, Sully. Live fast, die young. Leave a good-looking corpse.
Well, go and get breakfast at the cafe.
Can I grab a lift?
No.
Yes, sir.
Come up, Lee.
How is she?
Yeah. About what you'd expect. An almighty blow up at Robin before. Doesn't want him coming anywhere near Andrew.
A little odd considering that Robin saved his life.
Hmm. You try and talk him to get in some rest, eh?
I'll give it a go. All right. Stable at least. Oh, it could be worse. Are we weaning him off sedatives?
From the night. And, try getting her to take a break while you're at it. She's a woman on the verge.
Yeah, I heard. Okay, go and get some rest. I'll give you a call if there's any need.
No, I'm staying.
He'll be all right, Sarah.
He'll live, you mean?
And by this time tomorrow afternoon, he could be awake and complaining of a sore head.
I'd like that.
How did Mel's parents get so rich?
Business. They've got a ski lodge too.
For real?
Queenstown. It's got a helicopter pad.
Whoa. How come we didn't go there?
No helicopter. Hey, you're not complaining about this place, are you?
As if. And Noah's parents really didn't mind him lending the place to us.
They probably would if they knew. But they don't. So no. Can't have a bunch of kids like us coming in and trashing the place now, can we?
I never met the guy. What's he like?
I don't really know him that well. Seems okay. Bit of a jock.
He must really like you to hand over the key.
I guess. Hasn't really got that many mates as far as I could tell. Hey, what are you doing?
Just gonna check my messages.
They can track us using our mobiles. We shouldn't use them while we're here. Same as not using ATMs. We can't be tracked if we just use cash.
Well, I don't know about your dad, but my brother's probably too fed up to bother.
Well, they'll bother. And once we've been gone 24 hours, they can get the cops involved.
Great, just what I need before my court case. If I get in any more trouble, they'll lock me up and throw away the key.
I'm
go. We play each other in the first round?
Which only means you won't be making it to the second round.
I don't think so. You are going down.
Vicious sibling rivalry. That is exactly what we want. That and the profit. Ladies and gentlemen, $10 entry. All proceeds go to... Robin, you in for some table soccer food?
No, I don't think so. Your attention, please. We've just found out about another home invasion.
What?
And once again, it was someone who works here.
Who was it? Are they okay? Why the hell can't they just catch this guy?
Well, have they done the DVD thing again?
I won't go into details. The staff member in question doesn't want to go public, and I don't want anyone prying. Gary's here to give us some pointers on security.
Just use your common sense and keep your eyes open. You can always page me, and I'll walk you out to your cars at night, but... The way I see it, the likelihood of anything happening around here is pretty slim. The guts of the matter is, you don't want this guy finding out where you live. So keep an eye out for anyone following you, and if there is someone, drive to the nearest police station. And do I really need to remind you to lock your doors and windows? But remember, this bloke's good at alarms and security systems, so those of you living on your own might like to think about moving in with friends for a while. Just till he's caught.
You know where this guy is? Give me 5 minutes alone in the room with him.
Have a cuppa and then grab a shower. There's a change of clothes, a toothbrush, just the basics.
Oh, thanks, Tony. You can barely think straight. How are you?
Oh, a bit tired. Haven't been sleeping well since I left Chris. Anyway, the latest news is that the cops have found the car that tried to hit Andrew.
Whose was it?
They think it was stolen. The thief set fire to it when they dumped it.
So we'll never know if it was Joyriders or someone else.
Andrew, got any enemies that you know of?
Only his mad little sister.
Are you going to report her missing?
She's in enough trouble. And besides, she'll come back when she picks up her messages and hears about Andrew.
Yeah, I guess.
Look, about last night. Oh, I meant every word.
Look, I know we're not exactly bosom buddies, but we are in the same boat right now. We both care about Andrew.
Do we? I love him. God knows what twisted stuff's going on in your head.
Look, all I'm saying is if you want to talk, I'm here for you, okay?
How about being somewhere else for me? Say, in hell?
Bit harsh, wasn't it?
Do you trust her as far as you could spit?
Not really. Watch your back.
Claire, quick. Claire.
What?
Someone's coming.
Shh.
I don't know. My dad or your brother, maybe? The cops.
Get down.
Right. You're next. Adrenaline thumping?
Man, you better believe it.
You must be Claire. Noah Campbell?
Pleased to meet you.
What are you doing here, bro?
What can I say? You've got a new house guest.